Can we end all violent crime, even murder, by genetically engineering designer babies who are not only immune to diseases, but also less aggressive and more compassionate? And more importantly, if we can, should we do it? Join us today as we explore this topic from multiple perspectives. Stick around until the end, and we'll also share our summary of the three most influential peer-reviewed research papers on the subject. In recent years, advancements in genetic engineering have skyrocketed, giving rise to the possibility of creating so-called designer babies with specific potential traits such as intelligence, physical appearance, and even immunity to certain diseases. While this technology offers the promise of eradicating hereditary illnesses, enhancing human capabilities, and potentially even reducing violent crime, it also raises profound ethical dilemmas. Is it morally justifiable to alter the genetic makeup of future generations? There's no doubt that genetic engineering has already provided humanity with invaluable benefits. For example, by enhancing the resilience of plants and vegetables to pests, it has significantly reduced the need for pesticides. But altering the human genome is a whole different thing. The core question at the heart of this debate is whether or not we should tamper with the fundamental building blocks of human life. By selecting desirable traits for our offspring, are we inadvertently reinforcing harmful stereotypes or perpetuating inequality? Will genetic enhancements lead to a divided society where the privileged have access to superior traits, while the less fortunate are left behind? These are pressing concerns that demand our careful consideration. One striking implication of genetic engineering is the potential impact on crime and violence. If we possess the technology to eliminate genetic predispositions for aggression or criminal behavior, could we effectively eradicate the root causes of murder? Imagine a world where individuals are biologically inclined to be peaceful, empathetic, and honest. Would this herald a new era of harmony and cooperation? Or are we treading dangerously close to a dystopian reality where individuality is sacrificed for societal control? In navigating this ethical minefield, it is imperative to establish robust ethical guidelines and regulations to govern the use of genetic engineering in humans, ensuring that this framework is embraced and adopted by all governments, in alignment with the consensus of the global scientific community, is of paramount importance. Failure to do so will inevitably lead to increased inequalities, exacerbation of conflicts, and the abuse and oppression of developing countries by more powerful nations. If it's hard enough for two people to agree on what movie to watch next, how can we expect 8 billion people to agree on a significant and controversial topic like the tweaking of the human genome? Furthermore, who should have the authority to decide which traits are considered desirable or acceptable? How do we ensure transparency, accountability, and equitable access to genetic enhancements for all members of society? As you can see, there are still far too many unanswered ethical and moral questions that must be resolved before we can consider moving forward with any major edits to the human genome like the ones we've just described. Fortunately, real science doesn't work like Hollywood would want us to believe. Teams of scientists around the world are actively working to develop an ethical framework for this complex scenario. There are several robust, peer-reviewed research papers published in reputable journals. We'll include links to these papers in the description below for those interested in exploring the topic further. But in the meantime, we've read them for you, and here's our summary. This paper, published in 2019 by Mara Almeida, provides an overview of key ethical issues surrounding human genome editing, including concerns about safety, equity, consent, human dignity, and the possible risks associated with enhancing non-therapeutic traits, while highlighting the need for a balanced ethical debate as the technology advances. The second paper we selected, published in April 2020 by Jody Rothschild, explores ethical hurdles researchers face in developing gene editing technologies into viable therapies. It also discusses the need for the development and adoption of solid ethical frameworks from scientific and medical bodies. Our last pick is this peer-reviewed research published in November 2022 by Andrew M. Joseph and his colleagues. The main attraction of this paper is that it's a meta-analysis of 27 other studies, offering perhaps the most comprehensive overview of the topic. However, because of its very nature, it also includes some non-scientific viewpoints, so it's important to read it with a critical eye. There are many more papers, like the ones we just summarized for you, showing that the scientific community is actually paying attention to this topic, and not only from a purely technical and technological perspective, but also from an ethical and moral one. As you can see, there are still too many questions and not enough answers yet. But hey, what is the scientific method if not the best way to find answers to all questions? And it's comforting to see how the scientific community is actively and tirelessly working to sort out these ethical dilemmas. In conclusion, the ethics of human genetic engineering present a formidable challenge to our moral and philosophical frameworks. As we contemplate the future of humanity, let us remember that our choices today will shape the world we leave for future generations. Thank you for joining us on this journey of exploration and introspection. Until next time, stay curious, stay compassionate, and stay courageous.